Alright, hello and welcome to this, well, Zerg tutorial, I wanna call it, where we are gonna be going over the basics of Zerg gameplay. First of all is, of course, checking the Terran's team, or games, ratios. And yeah, the most important thing you need to realize, Zerg, is that you're not trying to kill the Terran's early game. Rather, you're trying to get your eco going, deny as many gas as possible, because that's how the Terrans get economy, that's how they kill you. So the first thing you do is actually make sure you hotkey your hive, and then look at the Terrans, who's pushing out, who's not. And then you start building spawners on the Terrans immediately, the ones that are pushing out preferably. You can of course do like F2 mid or something, but usually not recommended. And rather rally your units individually, if you have the skill for it. And otherwise, yeah, I'm gonna split these spawners here. Three on one turn, three on the other. Luckily, the third one is not moving out. Usually you're gonna have like one or two turns that are not moving out, so it's gonna be fine. And then we see what kind of damage we can do. You can see the Zerg income on the top middle. Left is the top Zerg, right is the bottom Zerg. In this case, I'm on the right side. And yeah, I'm just gonna see which effect these extra spawners have here. And seeing that pink is not moving out, I'm gonna rerally these two spawners to the mid guy. Make sure one's learning is watching that gas, one is the other gas. And then we can do some fancy micro on the sides. Not really that important. Just try to kill marines early on, which is very good. We got one already. Alright, the way that Zerg works is you have supply on top right, which is used to build spawners. These loading spawners use 4 supply each. Make sure to target on gases. And you upgrade your supply on the hive. The first supply costs 600 minerals, and every other supply increases the cost by 125. Let's kill those SCVs here. So you want to make sure you are on top of your supply. And you gain more minerals by both building extractors and spawners. That is the most important part that most newer Zerg players don't understand, because it's not as obvious. On the bottom here you can build an extractor, and you can see in the bottom text it currently gives you 66 minerals per minute. And here is a container, which you can't build early on, but it says that you would get 48 minerals, and that is basically four spawners worth of income right there. If you could pick an existing extractor, you can actually see that currently each extractor gives additional 67 minerals, and each spawner, or four spawners, would give 48 minerals per minute. So in our case, we can get more minerals right now by building extractors, which is why I'm gonna do that. And then we keep an eye on our Terrans, how well we push them in. Again, make sure to deny as many gases as possible. You can actually see this guy is slightly running out of minerals, energy on his marines. Alright, and we can see both our bottom turns are on one gas soon. So let's check our income real quick, and you can see we're still getting more money by building extractors. So I'm gonna build a third extractor here in this case. If you have more pushing Terrans, then you can of course build additional spawners. It's better to build spawners early. You can always get your income later. Of course, getting fruit farms is also a nice bonus, but I don't think we have the forces to actually kill him here in this case. Look at what ally is doing. Yeah, doing nice stuff. What you usually want to avoid is upgrading spawners, because they don't provide any additional income. And as I said earlier, you can't actually kill Terrans early. Okay, you see a low ground cheap farm, which is an indicator of low skill. So we don't need to worry about this guy. So at 725 minerals, we get the next supply, which is probably going to be going into some spawners. But yeah, the spawners you should build early on is slowlings, because they are the cheapest, provide the most income boost. So, yeah, even though my extractors are still worth more money, I'm gonna build a couple of additional slowlings here. just to make sure that these Terrans don't get the idea of moving out. Okay, and then I have 32 supply left, which means I can build 2 more extractors. You can see it's still quite worth building extractors because my ally has only built spawners so far, which is very nice, so we're gonna take advantage of that. Of course, spawners count globally for the Zerg, and the extractors are your own income, basically. That's how that works. You can see there are some Reapers here. Make sure we keep an eye on the bridges, actually. I should have done this earlier. Some Terrans like to be cheeky and grab the bridge eco instead. So it's always good to keep an eye on that. And extractors should of course always go into your main base. There they are protected. And look at that, there was an SCV there. That's okay, I'm gonna send one slowly over to that gas. You can see he's trying to take this expansion. Let's see if he can do some damage there. If he's building more, then make sure you target down the SCVs first. And we can actually rally some more spawners over here. Alright, let's keep an eye on the Terrans. Okay, nothing too threatening down here. And let's get our next supply upgrade. And looks like my ally wants to build some spawners now, some extractors. So I'm gonna let him do that. I'm only gonna build one, and then I'm gonna go into more slownings. And you can see this bottom Terran is actually trying to establish his other gases. So let's try to prevent that by building more slowlings on him. Usually the first set of spawners you want to build in the front, because that's where you're gonna have the most effect. And let's see, is he only building one? Okay, he's only building one extractor. So let's try to build more ourselves. And there's a reason why I'm building extractors over here. It's not really that important. Only matters once you're pushed in. Alright, let's do a little cheeky trick. Let's rally these from the other side. Okay, you can see he's building lots of Reapers. Which of course means free energy for him. Make sure you have some links on the walls at least. No, it's only have 2. And I'm actually gonna make sure that these are spread out a bit differently. So his shock trooper ability is not that impactful. And you can see he's actually trying to build a double layer here, which I'd like to prevent from happening. Not that it matters too much, it's only gonna hurt his ego. Okay, nice. Alright, let's keep an eye out on our income. Let's see, our ally is still only building spawners, which is very bad actually. It's usually good to get a somewhat competent Zerg ally. Otherwise it's gonna be pretty hard to win against Terrans, especially since, top seems fairly competent Terran-wise. Alright, and then I'm gonna build an extra set of slowlings. I'm actually gonna put these further in the back now, because we've reached the point where Terrans can get Shattering Laser, and so no matter how much pressure you put on them, they are likely to hold. I'd like to destroy these extra tumors here, because they just block vision, or building space rather. Alright, one upgrade you could consider getting is getting the Pact Mass. If you see that your Terrans are running low on energy, like this one is. And I mean, it's a nice upgrade and I have the eco for it, so I'm gonna get it. And around the 8 to 10 minute mark you also wanna grab Armor 1 research for a couple of infestors. Don't get attack upgrades early or speed, it just slows down your eco. Your goal should be ideally to get around 3k eco by 14-15 minutes each, that is. Alright, let's get some infestors. You make them from hatcheries, and infestors are special units from Zerg. They are energy based and can build special spawners, as you can see here. Usually worth getting are these 3. The Revertor, the Infused Roach, and the Taurisk spawner. But for those you need to gather energy. And you gather energy over time, 1 energy per second. They start at 50. Or you get 3 energy by actually attacking stuff. Wait, yeah, there it says. But what Infestors are going to be most useful for is for healing Big Spines. They have a Transfuse ability, which costs 150, and that's the main defense mechanism of the Zerg in the mid-game. Of course, it all depends on the turns. Alright, we have 8 Infestors. That's a good number to get early on. And seeing as my Elder is getting nothing, and yeah, you can see here, he's built a whole bunch of spawners on Bubbles. But Bubbles is actually just holding very comfortably. And he's already being pushed on the other side, so yeah, I mean, it's fairly likely that we lose this game because my ally doesn't understand how Zerg eco works. But it's okay, that's part of why I make this video. Alright, let's see, can we feed them somewhere? Yeah, let's just let them sit there, not worry about it too much. Alright. Ideally you get to armor 5 pretty soon, but that requires each of you to have 4k income. Which we're probably not going to achieve by 20 minutes here, so... What I'm going to do past 10 minutes is get Striklings, because Striklings only costs 3 supply, which means you can build 10 spawners per, or like 15 spawners per supply upgrade. Which increases your income by quite a lot. It's just in the early game they are too expensive to afford. And I'm just going to let these rally over. Luckily we have one turn that we can completely ignore. For the most part, I'm actually gonna rally this guy over to the sides to have some vision. See what he's doing, and we can see, yeah, Black over here has a bunch of outside gases, which we of course want to deny, and our ally is not doing so, so I'm gonna use these Striklings to do that. And yeah, you can just see, like, massive amounts of, at some point turns will just be able to hold the tier 1 spawners indefinitely. Actually, let's check this win rate. Yeah, as expected. It's not very high. But I'm gonna try my best to deny as much as we can. Alright, let's keep an eye out on these Striklings. Should be enough to overwhelm any defenses he has here. Does he have some Reapers? He does. And he's actually paying attention. Okay, that's bad news for us. Alright. Well, looks like we won't be able to deny his gases. So I'm just gonna make sure I keep my eco, as in my spawners over here. And my ally is actually keeping up on, or getting more extractors now, so I'm gonna be building spawners to supplement this. Let's just make sure we don't lose too much here. What I just used there is the absorbing cloud ability from the nest, which drains 3 energy per second and slows down the movement of Terrans. And you can see he's trying to get this gas down there, which we should be able to deny comfortably. So, and then we should look into armoring up at some point, because we're gonna need higher tier units to deal with these Terrans. So actually part of my slowings are still over here. Is bad news, or Striklings rather. Let's try to snipe his back gas if we can. See, is he paying attention? He even has... yeah, okay, he's being ignored completely. Good, it means we need to try to carry solo, which is quite impossible as Zerg. Okay, yep, we are spawner heavy now, or extractor heavy, which means, actually no, we can still get more extractors. Well, let's try to do that. And my goal is to hopefully get to infused roaches. I'm actually gonna grab a couple more infestors because I'm gonna have to transfuse this big spine over here probably. Let's make sure we don't lose too many high energy infestors. Alright, my ally has finally reacted to this guy doing stuff. Let's see. Well, looks like we are under heavy pressure over here. So there was a gas I'd like to deny down here. If you keep most of your Lurk Run by 15 minutes, it's actually quite good still. So. And now these should automatically rally over there. That's good. That's good. Okay, ideally we don't float as much. Well, let's just get a couple more extractors. And I could go for roaches here, but roaches don't really do too much against Terrans anymore. Which is why I'm trying to not get them. And rather max out on striklings first. You can build a maximum of 30 striklings. And also need to keep an eye out on the top left, because yeah, he's surely gonna try to be funny here soon and push this big spine. Which is why I'm gonna keep these infestors here, trying to heal them. Let's get one more supply upgrade while we're at it. And we actually didn't have enough energy, okay. Well, that's bad news for us. And our Isla also didn't get any infestors, okay. Let's grab one more supply upgrade. Actually just move this into a greater extractor, which is the same as three normal extractors. It's the same cost, but it's faster to build. Alright, yeah, this is gonna be interesting. I'm almost maxed out on striklings. And I have more Zerg gameplay on my channel if you want to watch that with competent allies. And against more competent Terrans as well. It's just I'm really being hindered here by my teammate. Alright, my goal is here to build more more spawners, because yeah, we're getting close to the cap here. And I want to apply some more pressure on bottom. And I'm just hoping that Black messes up somehow, but he doesn't look to be messing up. Okay, let's check his marines. He is actually still on standard and veteran marines, okay. And my ally just got armor 2. I'm gonna ignore that for now. And rather try to increase my eco some more. Okay, I'm gonna get one more greater extractor here. See, bottom is luckily not pushing out. So my goal is here to get to around 5k, because my ally isn't. And then try to crush Black with higher tier units. I mean, I could try to go armor 3 and primal roaches, which are also not too great. But would certainly deny his third gas. So yeah, let's get one more. Can we allow it? Okay, let's get one more extractor and a bunch more spawners, and I'm gonna put them on the top side, or rally them to the top side rather. But I'm actually gonna build them down here, because then they're less likely to die. That's the basic idea. And yeah, you can see Pink is still just holding against all of this nonsense. Alright, let's make sure we rally them to the back here. And get these strikings as well. Just so here's some more things to think about. Alright, I'm almost at 5k. Let's get one more greater extractor, and that should be the last extractor I should be getting. And then I'm gonna be going up to armor 3. Yeah, my ally is actually getting roaches. Which is fine, because only one guy is pushing. Alright, speed upgrades are an option to consider now. And not a bad one. I should really actually check this gas down here, that it's not been taken. But I don't think it's gonna be too much of an issue. Luckily our bottom towns are quite passive. Alright. How hard is he dying? Can we? Okay, we actually can't just ignore him. Because my ally is gonna die. Or is he? If you have spare time, or just get a couple more infestors. Let's see, we are getting close to Primus. Okay, I might actually take a quick stop and make a couple Primus here. 100 Primus infused roaches, they cost 700 energy. We're almost there. We are almost there. Alright, he's trying to get his nest. We can try to snipe it with the big spine. If we time it correctly, we can deny a buggle. And I think we made it, yep. And Bago denies more gas as well. Alright, am I trying to get infused? I am definitely trying to get infused. Okay, first spawner and second spawner should also be going down. Ideally you get like 3 or 4. That way they have the most effect. I'm gonna try to keep them away from the edges because Terrans can shoot over those. And yeah, looks like I'm gonna have to send some guys over. Yeah, roaches just melted, especially the unupgraded ones. Might have to keep some units here. Gonna get a roach spawner myself. And then I hope we can live for another minute. The ideal path would be go up to Brujas, is the most beginner friendly. That means armor 5. But we won't be able to do this here. Okay, let's actually do an F2 here. Try to stop him from getting our eco. And I'm just gonna send a couple of striklings over to deny his gases. Okay, looks like he just went for the bugger, that's good for us. Alright, I'm actually gonna get the roach upgrades from my ally, because I have the eco for it. And yeah, let's stop at 3 infused. Actually, no, I should get 4, but I also need upgrades and stuff like that. Yeah, let's get a speed upgrade. Just for the sake of it. And yeah, he's not really doing too much here, is he? Okay, let's help our ally out a bit with attack upgrades. Now he's actually chewing in walls. Yeah, he's almost attacking. Okay, yeah, let's wait a bit. And ideally I crush my bottom Terrans first. Because I'm quite sure I can't actually kill Black over here. Looks like bottom's moving out. We might be getting there just in time. So Infused want to have at least 5 attack upgrades with them. Ideally not a speed. If this guy is losing most of his units here, that would be very ideal for us. Okay, looks like the roaches are actually somehow working out. Let's see, eco ratio. Actually means we can get another infused roach. Let's see, do I have energy for it? I do not. Let's get speed 3. And let's try to. No, this guy's moving out. Okay, this guy actually has nothing. So, the way to deal with Marines is actually just walk past them. Like so. And try to just get into the Terran space. Your roach spawns are gonna do the rest. Okay. And that should be one Terran down. Just get his command center. Ignore the rest. And mission successful. Alright. We lost a bunch of spawners, it would seem. In the process, so it's always a good idea to rebuild them. Also for our income sakes, you see we lost a bunch because we lost spawners. Actually I would like to keep this big spine somewhat alive. So tier 1 spawners can spawn 2 spawners away. Well, looks like our boy is going for round 2. See what we can do here. Okay, this time I'm actually gonna attack actively. So, hello Ink, welcome to my Zerg tutorial. Should have turned off Discord notification. So, let's actually try to keep this big spine alive. Keep an eye on a little bit more spawners. Yep, you can see he's trying to do stuff. Let's see, do I have an infused roach? Okay, mission successful. Let's run in here. It looks like our roach is actually blocked. Oh great, I'm gonna try to get in somewhere over here. Looks like that's not happening. We can actually get another infused. Let's go up to the 4 we need. Yeah, the issue is still black over here, which we need to crush some point. Let's see, he has one wall upgrade, and actually just noticed that all these things are probably taken by somebody. Alright, I have a bit of spare supply, so I'm gonna get a Revertor to break walls easier. Yep, okay. That's very surprising that he's doing that. I'm just gonna kill these Reapers with these Roaches. I'm also trying to kill his base. Let's run a bit past here. Okay. These are his units gone. Let's save one infused roach. And yeah, this looks like a free base to me. Let's deny this guy's eco and let's get the Brutus finally. Get a couple more spawners. But yeah, the key takeaways here are get eco as early as possible, deny as many ghasts as possible. And then crush the Terrans in the late game, preferably. Alright, I'm gonna replace this creep here. Just so we have some space to build. And then I really need to look into killing this Terran down here. Let's actually make sure we get our units in. Let's check, can we kill any other Terrans? I mean, top Terrans are actually not that threatening, but I'd rather deal with my side first. Yes, you do. Let's actually go around the other side. Alright, let's get one Brooder spawner, send it to the top. Don't get too many Brooders, they are quite supply expensive. Let's see what we're doing down here. Ideally, get the walls done first. So, we wanna walk into the space, ideally. Okay, this tech lab actually doesn't have too many charges. So, let's try to get all our units. Okay, I'm hoping that red is not pushing out, or black is not pushing out, rather. So it looks like we denied his side gases. Okay, looks like one roach made it through. That's good, let's target down the rest of his base. Try to get in here, get his sheep. Sheep provide a nice little mineral boost. Which we dearly, dearly need. Okay, and I think we should have him here. Let's grab our infused roach, just keep an eye out on top. And I think we should just be able to walk in. Kill the space. Alright, let's look at top. Is top dying? Nope, not yet. It's good for us. We still need to get way more eco than that. Okay, although the balance is not quite there yet. We will need to kill this pushing army. I'm gonna get one more tech upgrade and then I'm gonna get a bunch more spawners. Make sure to run past him. Get as much damage done as possible. And let's replace the spawners we have lost. And I should probably put some of my infestors next to his big spines. Okay, that's his army gone. I'm gonna have to place a couple more brooders on this side just to keep Black's energy in check. But this is a high risk area here because we have no more spines, so it's likely we're gonna lose them at some point. Let's see, are we in? We are kind of in. Okay, brooders are doing work. You can see Black is pushing out, I just caught it on the remap. Okay, I think we just killed him. Somewhat anyways. Okay, yep. That was a nice catch there. The infused buff with the big spines. Alright, we could try to get Taurus now. Taurus are still even more expensive. Well, we might have to. Okay, Taurus cost 90 supply, so I'm gonna try to go for that. Although, since my ally is not getting any eco, I'm actually gonna get one more supply of eco. Check the balance, it's quite balanced. We've done a good job at balancing our eco. Okay, there's only one Terran left here. Okay, this is still some residual wars. That is fine. And all our spawners can now go to the top. We're losing a bunch down here. Let's not worry about it too much. Let's rally all these spawners to the front. And let's just try to kill this guy somehow. His war levels are quite high, I presume. Actually only 3, okay, that's fine. I'm gonna delete one brooder spawner to get 90 supply. And then I'm gonna get one of these Torlisks, which are really good at breaking walls. And I'm gonna make sure I group that up with my other units. Let's get a couple of infestors to potentially heal that. So, let's get all these extra spawners from the sides here. And let's just make sure we get in here ideally. Grab a couple of his turrets, if he can. And get a second Taurus spawner. Do I still have a brooder somewhere? I think I do, right? Yeah. We don't need that guy anymore. Our ally has enough. And let's grab another one of these full energy infestors. And transform that into another Taurus spawner. Okay, I think it's okay to place it in front here. I don't think yellow is gonna push out no more. So we're gonna place it on the edge of the creep here. Alright, let's tell him. I should have probably told him sooner, but yeah. Yes, indeed. Luckily only one turn is left, so there's not gonna be much trouble. Breaking, I don't think. Let's try to give his wall another go. Let's send all these units to the front. And ideally we're breaking through the back side here. I'm gonna get another Revertor spawner, because they're quite decent at killing turrets. And let's also get some more creep for him. Actually, is he doing that right now? He is doing that right now. Nice. Okay, looks like he's also attacking from the other side. So we do want to break into his boss. Yep, when we are. Okay, let's just make sure we kill all these turrets. Because we're not gonna be doing much to those walls. We're floating a bit of minerals. I also unhard keep my hive. That is okay. So he just sold his yard. Let's make sure we actually break in his walls. Kill his turrets, kill this power pylon, which is supplying the energy, and then just get in here and grab his gas. His gas is the most important resource. And let's also check what he's done with his walls. Should be able to just kinda go in here. Let's see, did our Taurus already spawn? They did. And I guess we are killing all his other stuff first. Alright, we should have a second Tora spawning in a couple of seconds. With that Tora, I'm gonna grab a bunch of infestors to heal it. Check his wall levels, he's at 4 wall levels. Grab the gas. Make sure he doesn't get any more wall levels. Alright, let's gather all our units together. A nice little trick you can do. Let's see, did my nest spawn? Yeah. You can use the cloud ability from the nest to gain vision upon this high ground. We can potentially snipe this tech lab with a couple of revertors. Okay, second Tora's out. And at this point, if you have trouble breaking the Tyrant, it's always good to have 20k eco each at this point. Sadly, Myla didn't really go for it. Also depends on how much pressure deterrents apply to you. But if you're in this situation where the Terran has relatively low wall levels, you can actually just kind of try to out-attack damage him. It's very costly, especially since the cost increases every now and then. Oh, every upgrade, not every now and then. But let's just hope without any micro that these... We can also try to transfuse them, although I think we have just too many units here in order to be actually able to do anything. Yeah, our infestors can't reach. There's just too much stuff in front. Okay, we noticed. So we're not gonna do that. I'm instead gonna try to snipe his tech lab, as that is providing a bunch of resources or damage boost to him. Get out of this stasis cannon. Okay, we got it. Next up is his yard, which is on the other side. Luckily he was kind enough to place all these buildings in front. So we should be able to just kill it, hopefully. Okay, that means he now has no repairs anymore. Let's see if he can't heal this Tora up. Oh, well, we were quite slow. Maybe this infused has more luck. Okay, this was not my infused, was it? Actually, it was. Okay. Well, let's just kinda try do stuff here. The next wave of attacks should hopefully... Oh yeah, my ally was also gathering up units at the worst possible moment. Well, let's ignore that fact. Alright, let's get one more eco upgrade. You might need some more attack upgrades. Okay, and he's just built extractors. Let's just try to go in there. Hopefully we can do stuff. Kill enough of the units. Target down the armory, ideally. Okay, nice. Whew, alright. The endgame was a bit iffy. Our ally didn't really do too much, but luckily we were able to carry through. So, yeah, a few key points. Make sure you try to not upgrade spawners early, because that just delays your eco. Try to get as much eco as possible, while also denying deterrent as many gases as possible. Get infestors at around the 8 to 10 minute mark, 6 to 8 of them. Have them transfuse your big spines if deterrents push. And yeah, try to get infused roaches or brooders relatively early by 20 to 25 minutes. And if you're completely new to Zerkex, please start out as Terran, because in order to win a Zerk, you kind of need to understand what Terrans are capable of, and that is best done by learning how to play Terran first. Alright, well, that's me done for the video. I hope you learned something, I hope you enjoyed. Leave a like, subscribe, comment below, ask any questions, things that I might have missed or have not pointed out. And yeah, as I said already, there are many more Zerk videos on my channel, so check them out. And I'll see you next time. Bye.